The initiative is coming at a time when an estimated 17,000 persons are jobless, according to the statistics department. Mr. Josie says while he wishes the prime minister well in his endeavors, he does not envy him, since according to Mr. Josie, St. Lucians will be eagerly awaiting the better days which Dr. Anthony's government had promised.
I think it's absolutely necessary. It is absolutely necessary. After all, that's what the government campaigned on. I've been hearing stories as to how they will get that money, but that must be our priority, and fixing the Badilil and Soufre, you know. I think people are actually waiting to hear what the government, especially the Prime Minister and the Minister of Finance, has to say with regards to that.
Mr. Josie says the revival of the economy would involve sacrifices on the part of all stakeholders, including employers and employees. But he says the government must practice what it preaches by avoiding an extravagant lifestyle where, as he put it, government officials should not be seen driving the flashy vehicles and going on every overseas trip available.
It's not a matter of giving the private sector tax-free concessions, etc., etc., and leaving the workers and the trade unions out. All of us, the workers and the trade union representatives, the investor who is coming in will be given concessions, and the private sector. And the government itself has to play its part. The government cannot keep hiring people willy-nilly and changing people black as white, you know, like they did the first time, throwing out experienced people. We can't do that anymore, you know. So if it is a holistic approach where the private sector is consulted and involved and the trade unions, in fact, this would be a tripartite approach.
From his observation, Mr. Josie says St. Lucians are not as patient as before, and the onus is now on the government to deliver. For the DBS News World, I am Don Nicholas reporting.